narrator. It's really for you to decide what this scene means, cause I'm bonkers out of idea for what to explain here. Maybe you can shed a light in the comments down below for me and the others. Mimania is chatting with idol Mima. The scene then takes us to another scene of Double Bind. Such a great plot from the movie that the role that Mima is playing in Double Bind have the exact same problems that Mima is having in real life. Once again, Mima is confronted by idol Mima and led her to a chase scene, ending up with Mima being struck by a truck driven by Mimania. White lights. Turns out that Mima was just dreaming. Or was she? Some speculation says that Mima really died from that accident and she is awakening afterlife. I don't want to say it's in a good or a bad speculation. A theory is a theory, but I'm gonna have to disagree. Mima then invited Rumi over for a chat. She is starting to lose her sanity from here on out. She couldn't keep track of time, of where she is. She couldn't even grasp reality and keep off what is fake or an act. Her fear of idol Mima rises as she is terrified that her hallucination would take over and become sentient. Scenes from the movie, her reality, idol Mima, a character she played from the movie, there is no telling of what is real and what isn't anymore. Her mind is contorted. She doesn't even know what she believes in anymore. Did she went to Harajuku? Did she not? This is a really depressing and dark scene for me. We then cut off to a scene from Double Bind, talking about the murder victims of the story, where the perp will kill those already unnecessary for her. As we see, the nude photographer is watching it. He apparently ordered pizza, this happens. Amazing scene, wasn't it? And once again, not because of the blood and gory imagery, that scene is just so emotional. So, did Mima kill the photographer?
Photographer.
In the morning, we see Mima is being told about the incident and was in a shock. Hard to believe that she is the one who killed him, right? But what the heck do we know of what is real and what's not at this point? She herself is in confusion, and as Mima opens up the cupboard, there it is. The pizza delivery apparel full of blood in a bag she carried in Harajuku. Right, here is where things get interesting theory-wise. There are speculations suggesting that Mima never really killed anyone, and that the killer is Mimania controlled by idol Mima, in parentheses, Rumi, or it could just be Rumi herself. And the other speculations suggest that it is actually Mima who killed them out of spite, but she blamed it all on her other self, or in this case, idol Mima, for doing it. She did not want to see herself being responsible for the murders that happened. It's for you to choose which to believe, but I personally think that Mima isn't responsible for all of the murders. Right, then so how am I expected to explain how is the apparel stored in Mima's cupboard then? Well, this is gonna be a long shot, but bear with me. I believe what happened was Rumi was the one who killed the photographer. I really can't say it. Photographer. So Rumi is the one who killed the photographer directly while Mima is out shooting for double bind. As Rumi is done killing the photographer, considering how close Mima and Rumi was, it wouldn't be hard for Rumi to obtain a copy of Mima's apartment key. So Rumi went back to Mima's apartment after she killed the photographer to plant the blood-soaked apparel in Mima's cupboard. She left and locked the door again, which would explain the possibility of it was Rumi who put the attire there, despite the fact that the chain lock was locked from the inside in the morning. Listening to talks of her from others surrounding her that she is jinxed further discourages Mima and depressed her even more. Mima then hallucinates over the scene that she is about to play to only find out that it was another dream. Was it a dream? Was it not? Time and scene from the movie and even reality is really blurry here for Mima. She did the last scene for the movie and was asked to change to attend the after party. She ran past Eri-san and mistook her for still being a character from Double Bind, as to which she replied with, And we finally see the confrontation of Mimania, who thinks that the real Mima is an imposter. He tried to torture, rape, and kill Mima. The scene ends with Mima hitting a hammer right in Mimania's head. It was then followed by spotlights and the red background shines ever so brightly. Rumi found Mima in a messed up state, and as they check to where Mimania's body is at, it has disappeared. Doubting herself ever more, they left and took her back to Mima's room. It's weird how she said that she's taking Mima back to Mima's room and not her room. So apparently as we arrived there, Mima grabbed the phone and called Tadokoro-san, her agency's manager. To our surprise, his eyeballs was gouged out as his body sloped down and revealed that Mimania's body is beside him, missing his left eye. So what happened there? Who moved Mimania's body? Who even killed Mimania? Was it just a hallucination of Mima? So I believe that it is actually a hallucination from Mima's part, and that she was actually doing a scene from the movie. But then she tore herself up and make it feel as real as possible for herself, giving the impression that she actually went through it again. The real killer is actually Rumi. I believe that Rumi thinks that Mimania has no more of use for her, and that she didn't want him to take the killing blow of Mima to himself. She wants to kill Mima herself, and as for Tadokoro-san, knowing that he hooked up Mima with more movies with sketchy scene, she couldn't take it and pushed herself to kill Tadokoro-san. Also driven by the fact that the one who forces Mima to do acting in the first place was Tadokoro-san himself. Then it's quite noticeable that it's not Mima's actual room, indicated by everything is neatly placed and the fishes are still alive. Mima's actual room is in disarray, the fishes are dead, there are no more charm posters on the wall, and I sure as hell didn't remember there's a train rail in front of Mima's apartment. Rumi has actually made a replica of Mima's apartment in hers. Mima can finally broke the illusion of idol Mima by seeing her through the mirror and realizing that it was actually Rumi. The final confrontation happened between Rumi and Mima. They had a chase scene where Mima basically assassins greeted between roofs, and Rumi followed suit. So how did Rumi manage to do all this effortlessly? Well, the truth is she is running on fumes, just as Mima is, as we can see her in her reflection in the mirror here. Her chasing Mima effortlessly is just how Mima perceived things. This is a very important scene. Looking at herself in the mirror makes her realize that there is only one Mima. Her illusion of idol Mima is shattered by seeing herself and Rumi in the same mirror. Idol Mima is Mima. Real Mima is Rumi. Idol Mima is Mima. Real Mima is Mima. There is only one Mima. As Mima bashed Rumi's wig away, Rumi is exposed. Her wig is what keeps her a persona of Mima that she wants to be. And with it released, so is her perception of being the idol Mima. She then stumbled upon sharp glass and cut herself, limping towards the middle of the road, and showed us this. As a truck was closing in on her, she sees it as a spotlight of a stage, and Mima came to the rescue. I believe by doing this, Mima is actually saving not just Rumi's life, but also her own sanity. Years later, we see Mima and Rumi in a mental hospital, where Rumi is a patient. She is still trapped in her mental state of being Mima. We can tell that Mima has actually been a success without Rumi, since we can see that the nurses are talking of her, and she drove her own car now. And we close it out with this scene. Gives me goosebumps every time I see it. Is it Mima? Is it not? Watch the movie once again to know the answer. The pieces are there for you. It's not something that I should answer. Figure it out. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It's more of a recap than an explanation video, huh? I appreciate all of your comments, advice, criticisms, and feedback from the last video. I didn't even thought to hit like 100 views, but the last video is now at 12,000 views as of I'm writing this script. Thank you so much. I'm open for suggestions, so tell me what should I do or talk about in the next video. Maybe I can read you guys some spooky stories, or I can do a let's play of a horror game, or maybe just other recaps and theories about our movie, anime, or literature. I'm all ears. Just comment down below. Thank you so much once again for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already. I'll catch you guys later.